Hey guys, I'm Zach, and today I'm going to be reviewing Creality's Ender 3S1 Pro. I'm going to be diving into a bit of the background, story of this printer. I'm going to get into some of the specs, my experience using the Ender 3S1 Pro for the last year, the pros and cons I've found, and finally, if I still think it's worth getting now that there's a whole bunch of new printers out there like the Bambu Labs P1P and X1 Carbon, and the upcoming Creality K1 Speedy. The short answer is, yes, I do still think it's worthwhile purchase. In some cases, but let me explain why. So without further ado, let's get right into it. Okay, so let's start out by saying that at the time of filming this video, the S1 Pro is Creality's latest and greatest iteration of the super popular game-changing Ender 3 that came out way back in March 2018. God, I feel so weird saying that. Anyway, since that time, Creality has been churning out revision after revision, trying to capitalize on the Ender 3's success and implementing a bunch of upgrades along the way. But while this was going on year after year, the community around this awesome printer continued to grow and expand. And out of that community sprung some pretty incredible mods that made that budget printer into a 3D printing powerhouse. And along with all those mods, there was a whole ton of user feedback building up in the background. And Creality finally decided to take all those mods, like the BL Touch for auto bed leveling, which they turned into the CR Touch, and dual lead screws, direct drive extruder, etc., and a lot of that stockpiled user feedback and mash it all together to create an ultimate Ender 3. The Ender 3 S1 Pro is essentially a culmination of all of those mods and user feedback that sprung out of the Ender 3 over those 4 years. But at the end of the day, even with all those improvements, this is still at its core an Ender 3, for better or for worse, which we'll get into in a bit. But first, let me get into some specs. The Ender 3 S1 Pro has a build volume of 220 by 220 by 270 millimeters, or 8.6 by 8.6 by 10.6 inches for you Freedom Unit guys out there. It's about the same build size as the original Ender 3, if not slightly taller than the Ender 3's 250 millimeter build height. The build plate is heated up to 110 Celsius, 230 Fahrenheit, which lets you print some really demanding plastics. It has a spring steel PEI coated build plate that really holds on to your print while the build plate is hot, and when it cools off, it just pops right off, which is awesome and works very well. Moving on, it has a dual gear direct drive sprite extruder that lets you easily print more demanding filaments like TPU much more easily, and really is far more reliable in my experience. An all metal hot end that can get up to 300 degrees. Then you bang out prints in like CF nylon, ABS, and a lot of other more demanding filaments. Quick side note, if you plan to use the Ender 3S1 Pro to print out CF nylon or other more abrasive filaments, you're probably gonna wanna invest in a hardened steel nozzle, because otherwise your brass nozzle that this printer comes with stock is gonna get eaten away in like 4 or 5 prints. Of course, depending on the size of the print. But even if you're not gonna be printing sandpaper, I still think it's worthwhile picking one of these things up. But anyway, I digress. Getting back to it, you get dual lead screws to really stabilize the Z axis. And the chassis is made mostly of aluminum. I find it to be strong and tough. The base is ejection molded plastic with this little cute little drawer for your tools. And it kind of really gives you a premium feel. It comes with a light on top, which I find very convenient and useful for getting a really good look at that first layer. The S1 Pro comes with a filament runout sensor that lets your printer pause the print if the filament runs out and resume it using the 4.3 inch touchpad interface you get with this printer. This is a game changer if you're coming from one of those old knob and dial style printers, and it has a really clean and easy to use UI. And all of this runs off of a pretty powerful 32-bit board, which makes printing relatively fast and easy using the integrated Marlin firmware. All in all, this is a solid printer with a ton of features, which brings me to my experience with it over the last year. So I upgraded from my last printer to the Ender 3S1 Pro about a year ago, and I've been using this printer since then. Now, there's a lot of other printer enthusiasts out there that have like a million printers, but unfortunately, I just don't have the budget and the space in our place to store more than one printer at a time, at least according to my wife. And after doing some intense research, I decided to finally pull the trigger on this model. And the truth is, I really don't regret it. I mean, over the last year or so, I printed out a ton of different models. It's reliable and has incredible build quality. The only real issue I've had with this printer over the last year is that the extruder is kind of a nightmare to operate on. I had a few times where there's been like a really good jam right down in there. And the only way to fix it is to open it up and take it apart. But this is one heck of a process because all the externals of the extruder, like the fans and the CR touch, are all bolted on there on top of everything, one on top of the other. You can't, you have to take everything apart to really get the extruder opened up, get to the gears and pick that jam out, you know? But aside from that craziness, this printer has really been a pleasure to work with. The reason I decided to pull the trigger on this model at the end of the day, as opposed to like the quadrillion other printers out there, is actually for a few reasons. The first, I guess, is my experience with Creality as a company, and specifically using the Ender 3 in the past. This community support can be a huge plus, especially if you get some issues with your printer. Chances are someone out there has had the same experience and fixed it already. This is very important to me. The second reason I decided to pull the trigger is because of all the positive reviews I saw on this printer. And the third is because it has the ability to print some of the most demanding filaments out there. I mean, I really love printing in TPU and PETG and carbon fiber PETG, carbon fiber nylon, because I really like making useful and long-lasting stuff. And this printer can really handle them in a pinch, which takes me to the pros and cons. But first, let me just say, if you find you're getting value from this, I would really appreciate it if you would subscribe and like the video, because it really does help me out a lot. And I just want to show some quick gratitude to all the kind people I've met on this platform and all the people that have left some really amazing comments on my previous videos. Thank you guys. And with that said, up until now, I've been mostly positive in this review. So let's make it a little interesting and start with the cons. The first con, in my opinion, is the build size. In this day and age, there are multiple options out there that will give you a much bigger build size for an even lower price. I think that that's something that can actually make a big difference if you're looking to get this printer. I mean, that depends, of course, what it is you're planning on printing. Still is a bigger build plate size than the Prusa Mark III. So there's that. The second is the gantry. As opposed to other more premium printers like Prusa or Bambu Labs, the gantry on the S1 Pro uses V-slot wheels as opposed to linear rails, which are far more durable and sometimes can even be more accurate. And linear rails would really have been a nice feature on this one. Number three is breaking down the Sprite extruder. Although the Sprite extruder is a very reliable and powerful extruder, it is a real pain to disassemble and put back together if the need does arise on the rare occasion. Thankfully, there are a few step-by-step videos out there that can really help you out, which I've used. Let's move on. As for the pros, the first pro is that this is a very reliable printer. I've been using it almost daily for the past year, and aside from regular maintenance, I've had almost no issues with it. And that is saying a lot for a 3D printer. Number two, is the extruder. I know this is weird because this was in one of the cons, but bear with me for a second because the extruder is really powerful and very reliable extruder, even though it is a pain in the ass to take apart and put back together. Pro number three is the touchscreen. This touchscreen is large and bright, easy to use, and has a clean user interface. Now, I don't really use the touchscreen that much because I have the Sonic pad, so I've kind of switched that out. The touchscreen becomes redundant once you plug the Sonic pad up to it. So I kind of got that sitting in a cupboard over there. But for the short time that the touchscreen was actually connected to the printer, it was pretty cool. And it is a huge plus for the people that are upgrading from one of the knob style printers. Number four is the light. It makes a huge difference. Number five is the PEI coated build plate. Number six is it's incredibly fast to put together and it works perfectly right out of the box, making it a great choice for beginners out there in the hobby. Short story, when this printer arrived at my place from Amazon, I was on the way out the door to a family vacation with my wife and kids. And I somehow managed to convince my wife to give me and the kids an hour with it. And I was able to manage to put the thing together and bang out my first print within that hour, and it's been working perfectly ever since. Which brings me to why I think this printer might still be worth considering now that Bambu Labs has come out with the P1, PN, X1 carbon, and the new Creality K1 Speedy is up on its way. And the reason I think that the Ender 3 S1 Pro is still a viable option is because I find that there's something to be said in this world for community and legacy. And the Ender 3 was the first in a long line of 3D printers that smashed the price of 3D printing into pieces, making this incredible tool accessible to the masses. And in doing so, it brought about a small revolution and consumers 3D printers that we're still seeing to this day. And the Ender 3 S1 Pro is a product of years of user feedback and mods made by the community. Like I said at the beginning, therefore, with this printer, you have a huge community of support that we just don't have yet for the Bambu Labs printers that have taken the 3D printing community by storm in the last few months. That being said, the stock Ender 3 S1 Pro doesn't come close to the speed and ease of use features that the P1P and X1 Carbon have to offer. But if you're willing to shell out $160 for a sonic pad, you might be able to come close and still have some cash left. Being that at the time of filming this video, you can pick up the Ender 3 S1 Pro for about $400 on Amazon. And together with the sonic pad, that comes out to like $560, which is still more than $100 cheaper than the P1P. And considering you can't get Bambu Labs printers in a lot of countries around the world, this is definitely an important consideration because Clipper on this machine will turbocharge it. I have a review if you want to check out of the sonic pad. I'm going to link it down in the description along with some affiliate links for some of the most useful 3D printing gear I've come across on my 3D printing journey. You might want to check it out. Link down in the description. If you live somewhere that you can't get a Bambu Labs printer or you don't want to fork out $1,000 for a Prusa, I think that this is an incredible option. You might want to consider. If you like this one, you'll probably like this one next. Take care for now.